something called bittersweet nightshade or Solanum dulcamara. It has purple flowers. And red berries, and it has a distinct leaf with cloves at the bottom, at the base, and according to my research, that's bittersweet nightshade, not deadly nightshade. But if you Google deadly nightshade, you'll find lots of pictures of this plant, which is properly identified, in my opinion, properly identified as bittersweet nightshade. Deadly nightshade, the internet says, one leaf will kill you. The internet tells me that this plant, if you eat its berries, you might need medical attention. Children should stay away from it. Pets should stay away from it. But it says it's not as deadly as deadly nightshade, which, you know, I'm not a plant expert. So, you know, talk to somebody that is. But I actually want to try one of the berries and see what it tastes like. Anyway, here's a look at the plant. The leaves have sort of a cloven leaf, two leaves coming out of the bottom at the base of the main leaf. And see if we can get a picture of the purple flowers. There's the purple flowers. You'll find this plant, like I said, on the internet, identified. I've seen it in several sources being identified as deadly nightshade. But if you do a little deeper investigation, you'll find that deadly nightshade is a different looking plant. And here's a look at the berries. Berries are red. Deadly nightshade has black berries. Now, there's also a form of nightshade called black nightshade, which looks very similar to this plant, but is not actually deadly nightshade. So, anyway, I want to see, call me crazy, I want to see what this berry tastes like. I'm only going to eat one, but according to the internet, it's not going to kill me. It could kill me. I don't know if it's going to kill me, but I hope it doesn't. Anyway, I'm just curious to see what it tastes like. Like I said, don't try this yourself. Consult somebody who's a plant expert. It sort of tastes like a tomato.